Hey guys, and welcome back to Lord of the Rings Theory. In today's episode, I thought it would be interesting to explore the theory of what if Frodo and Sam had killed Gollum. Now, there are many plausible realities where Frodo and Sam could have killed Gollum. When their first encounter in Emmenmuel, Gollum attacks the halflings and they skirmish until Frodo wields his sword Sting upon the throat of the creature. There is also the Forbidden Pool, where Faramir nearly shoots the creature, as well as Sam overhearing Gollum's plans to harm the halflings on their path to Mount Doom. Whenever it happens, Gollum was crucial in the plot of destroying the ring. It's not a question of if they could have accomplished their task if Gollum was no longer in the picture. It's a question of how far along their quest they would have reached. The sooner Gollum leaves the picture, the more doomed they are on their near impossible task. It's likely that if the creature never stalked them, or if they had ended his life in Emmenmuel, Frodo and Sam would have kept traveling in circles and very, very slowly made their way to Ordered Ruin, by which time the ring would have had a mighty hold of Frodo, and their rations of Lemnos bread would run dry. To make this theory as interesting as possible, let's kill Gollum later rather than earlier. So, our story begins as Faramir wakes Frodo to show him something of great importance. He takes the halfling to the Forbidden Pool, where we see Gollum fishing. Faramir states and asks,
"To enter the Forbidden Pool bears the penalty of death. You wait for my command. Shall I shoot?"
This is where our timeline changes. Frodo had developed a soft spot for Smeagol, and the ring up until this stage of his journey had corrupted the halfling to trust Gollum. However, the ring had now decided to be rid of Gollum, for the creature was proving to be useful in the halfling's quest to destroy the ring. Frodo, who had remained silent for a few seconds, had now spoken. He gazed his head upwards at Faramir, who had his arm raised, with soldiers awaiting orders to fire their arrows. Without hesitation, the ringbearer cried, "Kill him!" On Faramir's command, the Ithilien rangers fired dozens of arrows, several of which pierced Smeagol. The creature let out a cry of pain before looking up to the origin of the arrows and seeing Frodo looking down at him. Smeagol howled, before he fell off the sharp rock and sunk into the now bloody Forbidden Pool. The next morning, Frodo and Sam were released, and since Gollum had not revealed that they had the ring, Faramir had no questions other than worrying as to why Frodo unhesitatingly confirmed the assassination of a creature who seemed to hold a deep affection for him. The rangers released Frodo and Sam, since he knew they were in league with his recently fallen brother, Boromir. Faramir never officially met Gollum in this timeline, and as a result, he would never learn of the ring being in Frodo's possession. Sam was relieved that Gollum had been slain, although he did not know that Frodo had ordered the slaying. The ringbearer had lied to Sam, telling him that the rangers had fired into him for entering the forbidden area, which carries the punishment of death. So it was, on March the 8th, Frodo and Sam depart Henethanun with Faramir's approval. Gollum had previously mentioned that the winding stair was the secret passage into Mordor, and that was their destination. In the canon timeline, Frodo, Sam, and Gollum depart Henethanun on March the 8th and arrive at the stairs of Minas Morgul on March 10th, where they witness the army of Mordor depart their stronghold of Minas Morgul to attack Minas Tirith. Back to the present moment, it is March the 8th. Frodo had just confirmed the assassination of Smeagol, and he, along with Sam, have just departed Henethanun with Faramir's consent. However, this time, without the guidance of Gollum, they were to become lost. 3 days had passed, It was now March the 11th, and the hobbits were hopelessly wandering between the borders of Gondor and Mordor. They knew they had to travel east. However, with Sauron's shadow looming over them, it was difficult to follow the sun. Sam began to faintly hear collective footsteps. "I wonder what that could be, Mr. Frodo," he said concerningly. "I better see if I can catch a sight of that clatter. Wait here, I'll climb that tree," reaching near the top of a lifeless tree and peering into Mordor. He could see an endless army of orcs marching in their direction. Sam climbed down the tree and told Frodo what he had just witnessed from his scout.
"Only 3 leagues away, marching towards us, you say?"
Frodo replied. "I wish we could warn Faramir and the men of Gondor to prepare. I wonder if that was the purpose of the giant beam that blasted through the sky last night. To signal for the armies of Mordor to march forward for war." "It may have been, Mr. Frodo." Then something spurred through the memory of the gardener.
"Mr. Frodo," he cried. "That Gollum, when he stopped us from storming through the Black Gate, and he told us of that secret passage we are searching for, he mentioned it was next to an old fortress, the fortress which was built by Isildur and is now under the influence of evil. The old rat mentioned that many orcs live there. You don't suppose that's where they are marching from, do you?"
"I don't miss that old villain. However, the stinker was useful in guiding us, and I imagine if he were still around, we may have arrived at the secret stairs by now." Sam continued.
"Mr. Frodo, alas, this may be our opportunity. If we follow the trail of orcs, we can be led straight to their evil lair, where our passage lies. We will be led to their fortress, like breadcrumbs. Except these breadcrumbs would harm us awfully if they were to catch a glimpse of us."
Sam Gamgee felt mighty proud of the plan he had just conjured, although, in his concerned facial expression, the peril of their plan was very foreseeable.
"You're right, Sam," said Frodo. "An opportunity has presented itself, and we must seize upon it. We must hasten. Our food rations are lessening, and we have not been voyaging wisely since the loss of Gollum. If we track them from a distance, we can follow them to their origins. We will need all of the luck we need. Thankfully, we have the elven cloaks of Lothlorien. I imagine they will never serve us better than they will over the course of this mission." With that, they began to pace towards the orcs, who were marching vigorously, and on March the 16th, 5 days after they began their stealthy charge, they successfully arrive at Minas Morgul and see the secret stairs which leads to Shelob's tunnel.
Okay guys, that's where I'll end part one. Now, I'll turn the story over to you. Let me know where you think this theory should go from here. Obviously, without Gollum, there will be a lot less cunning and deception in this alternate timeline. Drop a comment down below of what you think would occur from here. And if this video reaches 100 likes, I'll make a part 2 structured around the most adept theory that I see down below. Be sure to like, subscribe, and share this video with your peers. Hope you're having a wonderful day, wherever you are. And as always, my Middle-earth friends, hunt on for watching, and I'll see you on the next episode of Lord of the Rings Theory.
Embrace the power of the ring, or embrace your own destruction.
Renewed shall be blazed.